You know, there's a brother that came in the game raw since a young man. You know what I'm saying? He's been on the grind ever since. You know, I just want to welcome him to Screwball Radio. You know, we live from the Matrix. My brother J Hood. Let's get it
peace,
going.
Peace.
Peace,
what's good, Comet?
What's good? All right, man.
Infamous J Hood in the motherfucking building.
Yeah, Blaq poet.
That's good too. What's good, Don?
Peace.
J Hood in the building. Pardon. What's good, bro?
Man, ain't nothing, man. You know, just cool. It's cool. It was a good Saturday, you know.
Yeah, I know you was listening to us chop it up. You know, it's very political, you know.
Interesting conversation, yeah.
Yeah, we like touching on all bases and, you know, what's your opinion on where we at?
As far as what the conversation that y'all was having?
As far as, yeah, the craziness outside, man. You know, white boys running up in places. Like they just did that not too long ago, upstate Connecticut or was it Boston, where the guy went in and just started shooting, you know, African Americans for what reason? And now you got it again going on at the Dollar Tree down in Florida. And,
If I am mistaken, you might be talking about the situation that happened up in Buffalo, right?
Yeah, Buffalo. I think it was like a supermarket or
right,
something like
yeah.
that, but it's like the same reoccurrence, just every state is dealing with the same bullshit, the same racism, systematic racism,
right.
Like for no reason.
Right, I mean, someone had an interesting take on that not too long ago, and I kind of agree with it, right? What he was saying was that, you know, since the thing that happened in, what was that, Alabama? When they were going crazy
yeah.
with the chairs and all that, it was like, listen, man, they're going to want some type of payback. You know what I mean? So everybody got to be on high alert. So,
but again,
sure.
Again, with the Alabama thing, you know, just a security guard letting the white folks know that they couldn't park their boat there. That
right.
that wasn't there for them. They didn't want to listen. They start getting all violent with the security. And, of course, people, you know, they're going to hold them down. And that's what happened. People came and
right.
stuck up for him and helped him
absolutely.
When he was being outnumbered, you know, because that's what it was. He was being outnumbered. And people ain't standing for that no more.
It's the entitlement. You know what I'm saying? Like, they think they're entitled to certain rights. I mean, for the simple fact that, you know, the rights within this country was constructed and built for them and not for us. So, you know what I mean? They're the ones who benefit from it. So, that's where the entitlement comes into play.
Yeah,
that's true. They don't want to take no L
true.
At all, especially a public L.
Right.
Yeah, just got
yeah
watch
you know. Yeah, you definitely gotta, you know, you always gotta hold your, you
but
gotta watch
like,
that.
It's not gonna
not
be
no,
it's not gonna be something that's gonna stop though. Like you said, it's a recurring thing and it's gonna keep occurring because it's just the mentality and, you know, the it's what America's threaded in. It's threaded in racism. It's like, it's not new. It's something that's been taking place since the beginning of this country, you know, so.
Yeah, for sure. For sure.
It's just magnified at the level that it's magnified at now because of, you know, we have social media, so as soon as something happens, we know immediately. You know what I mean? And
yeah.
And things of that nature.
I think the hip hop community can, you know what I'm saying? We don't play that shit in the hip hop, you know. I think we can really fucking make a difference in that shit if we focused on that shit more. Like back
now,
in the
we
day,
definitely
yeah,
could. See, the thing that be, you know, getting me upset about the whole like situations like that is, and this is just me being realistic and speaking from, you know, a realist standpoint. Like we got all the G'd up niggas and the gangsters and the hitters and all that. Niggas are clap at each other. You know what I mean? Like hit each other and gun each other down. But when it comes to you know what I mean? Like really putting in work on some people that stands against us. They more like they're reluctant to fighting back or doing something to someone that, you know, looks at us in that type of light.
You never in history heard about no gangbanger shooting a KKK member.
Yeah, nah, it don't go down like that. You know what I mean? Because for some reason they scared of the repercussions, you know, that they have to face after, you know, doing that or possibly doing that to someone of the opposite color. And that's the thing that's puzzling to me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we ain't saying go out there and just fucking shoot up shit like that, but
you know, definitely not.
At least,
I mean, it's not like that. Like
go at niggas. If you're gonna go at your brother, go at the enemy too.
Right, exactly.
Same enemy.
Like nobody should be exempt from that. Like if your mentality is a mentality of a hitter, you know, at least use at it and, you know, put your courage to use. You know what I'm saying? And ride for a cause.
I mean, like, you know, back in the day, you know, let's you know, for example, the Rodney King issue.
Mm-hmm.
Rodney King happened, LA went crazy.
Right.
You know? And a lot of it was, you know, they didn't have to like burn down buildings or anything like that. But they did stand up against, you know, fucked up policing. They did start, you know, controlling their neighborhood and protecting their neighborhood. You know, that's why the Black Panthers was around, to protect their neighborhood from outside interference. But nowadays,
and that's why they had to get them
people,
up out of here.
Yeah, exactly. But today, people they say they soldiers and people say they, you know, they for the, you know, for the hood, but truly they just really for the pocket. You know what I'm saying? And what they get out of their hood and how they burn down their own hood. But they won't build their hood. They won't police their own neighborhoods. You know what I'm saying? That's how you combat shit like this, is when, you know, you stick up for your hood. Like, this is our hood. You ain't going to come in here and do all the fuckery to our hood. Like, you're not doing that.
Cause
we got moms here. We got kids here. You know?
Yeah.
There's no structure.
But a lot of the times, the people that be speaking on shit like that, like you said, are the people who is not taking taking steps to doing anything in the hood, and those are people that's just speaking about it online. You could be anything you want to be online. You know what I mean? You could be a philosopher, you could be an activist, you could be all that. You know what I mean? But in real time, it's something totally different. And I'm gonna tell you,
like,
Let me ask y'all something. This is some real shit though. Y'all familiar with Sundown Towns? I mean, Sundown Towns.
Sundown Town, what's that?
The Sundown Towns are towns that exist within the country that more so don't like people of color in their towns after the sun go down. Like, if you get caught there after the sun go down, it's ugly for you. You know what I mean? Like, for the police and from the people of the city in which those sundown towns are in effect. You know what I mean? Mostly Caucasian people. They don't like...
Yeah, like at the south.
It's like
New York,
West, a bunch of places.
Howard Beach, nigga. Niggas in Howard Beach, remember they did that shit, they changed the homie do stuff. Focus back in the days, man. Howard Beach is one of them towns you talk about right there.
Yeah, people, see, this is the thing, right? People think all this stuff is non-existent in today's climate and all that, but nah, we have so many sundown towns, like, right now in this day and age, we wouldn't believe it. So when we talk about, you know, certain situations that take place, like the dollar store shooting and all that other type of stuff, we have towns right now that Black people can't be in when the sun go down and or certain stuff will happen, man. And people just don't know about these spots, but these little towns are right beside places where we live at and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? It's crazy.
Yeah, I think it's also
more psychological. We don't do that to the people in the hood. Like, the hood is crazy, but white dudes would be good in the hood, you know?
Right. That's what I'm saying. Like,
fuck with niggas.
Right. Exactly.
That's crazy.
See, we have a history of being like kind-hearted and more open. you know what I mean, to embracing people and showing love and all that type of shit. Like you said, there's no real structure when it comes to, what should I say, there's no, like, real military mentality as far as, like, yo, listen, we got to set this precedent. We have to stand for this, and we have to do this, and we can't allow certain people within our community and all that, because a lot of people just infiltrate what we be having going on, and we allow it by being so welcoming. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, yeah, because, you know, we peaceful people, though. We peaceful people. Like, we only going to give you problems if you come with a problem. You know, they don't think outside the box. They don't think, yo, let's stand for one another. It's more, yo, if you come in my face and you come popping shit to me, I'm going to hit you. But, you know, they just do it a different way, and they come causing trouble. But we so caught up in, yo, who got beef with who, that they ain't looking at that as a beef. So it just comes in secretly, and boom, people die, and then you want to speak about it.
Right. Yeah, and that's not only an issue with violence in our communities, but it's also a monetary issue within building or establishing businesses in our community. We're more so more quick to support, you know, foreigners and their establishments than we are to support people within our own communities that look like us starting businesses. You know what I'm saying? We'll let somebody else move into our neighborhoods and, you know, milk us for our money instead of building something, you know, that would be substantially lucrative and support that.
Oh, yeah, because they don't want to see you do better than them. They'd rather give it to somebody else they don't know.
Yeah, it's a sick psychological thing. Like,
yeah, when you spend money in your neighborhood, that just boosts the economy in your neighborhood.
Right.
Instead of it being run down and raggedy, but, you know, like you said, you know, they want to go in the Chinese store and buy the hair instead of going in the sister store and buying their hair. You know, they want to go up in here and let's just say, Macy's.
Yeah, no disrespect to Macy's. No disrespect to Asians and the Ox and all that. No disrespect, but we just speaking realistically. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, man.
It's the truth. But yo, E, I know, you know, we've been chopping it up politically and all that. You know, let's give the people some of Hood's, you know, a couple of his old bangers, then we'll come back and chop it up with you with what you got going on right now. And yeah, Jay Hood,
what's up, man?
Screwball Radio,
definitely.
Yes, sir.
Locked in.
What up? D-Block and QB, nigga. Get at me. It's another one of those AMC things. It's the riders in the mall.
This is it, homie. We're gonna go with this one right here.
It's the riders in the mall.
Yo, I'm never empty-handed, understand, son? I keep a fist full of cash, the other on some ass, son. Smack the shit out, niggas, like handball. Or I give them a fair one. They ain't gon' do nothing, I dare him. I hear him, he a gangster, he don't take crap. And so I point this carry at him, tell him, take that. In fact, I'm about to blow, but that you already know. Shit, I just trap, holding cracks just a minute ago. Now I'm in the jag with the rag, and the tips is low. And you mad, cause you a fag, and your chick's a hoe. Yeah, she been around more than any bitch I know. You should be glad though, I taught her everything she knows. What you reaching for? What I done touched the nerve. You wanna hurt something, now you know I'm fucking your bird. Cause that's my word. Front like you wanna war. And homie, we can settle the score. You waiting for?
Yo, I'm a Tracy McGrady of this shit. I take you right to a hole. Shove the tip of the nose of the silence of right in your nose. That niggas is degenerate. It don't make sense to do business with a nigga if you ain't gon' benefit. Fuck a Bentley and a jet. I'm gutter, nigga, check it. All I need is 2.5 and a couple intrepid. It's drama, I ain't staring you down. I'ma clap your forehead and dump you with one of the merry-go-round. Slipping past the cracks in the street to get you a stack. It's being added since they made the first box of Cracker Jack. Beating the staircase, purple up, rolling the back. that bottle of yak next to me. On my lap is a Mac. It's slug sticks you, they take in your arms. D-Block got the kind of weapons that push, trying to take you to dumb. From Y.O. to your hood to QB. Catch me chugging it out, shooting dice, twisting up for OG. Now faggots don't know me, it's no remorse on how I look for your corpse. I'ma try to find you dead on your porch. But the riders in the mob, in the mob.
That's what I'm talking about. Yo, yeah. Like white on rice, I be on you. You couldn't even shake me off. Be in your chest like a smoker's cough. Put the hammer in your mouth and now you sucking it off. Like a whole time stop before she find the law. You in the club, you the dub, why you playing the door? Like you know, son, I don't play it and put me on. You got me so nervous, I got bras and to get it on. With any fella in big before they talk. Mind like a nigga on the road taking his last walk. And when I come, niggas kissing and cross. You know you done fucked up now. Niggas talking just to be talking, ain't nothing sweet but the pound. Repeatedly vow to never go against the grain. Know I've been doing it since a little stain. Pull a hammer, move you right out the lane. Niggas talking out the ass like you just sniffed cane.
My niggas live life with a death wish. Smoke for breakfast. A lot of people hope that I'm breathless. Wanna send my ghost to the essence. Go ahead, nigga, I don't care, I heard the light was fluorescent. Niggas count they ones, but never they blessings. To the at the wrong end, end of the west end. D-Block, five-star general. Die hard like Bruce Willis, nigga. I could put an end to you. Rum robbing soldier, cold as Antarctica. I'ma make the plans to pick your man's daughter up. Big 45 in the sweats of my Nautica. 55 bricks, but I'm trying to pick my order up. All my niggas flow, nobody watered up. Shoot to the gun empty, then nigga sort it up. Anytime pee in the booth, nigga record it up. G-Hope's toast, I kill niggas when the quarter's up.
Quarters up.
I don't know nothing about Alchemist. Who is he?
Sam, I've got a wild one for you.
What is it? Dropping, nigga. A nigga been nitro while I'm killing it when it's cypher time. I always held my own cause I had the knife to line. Niggas ain't got it for me like a worker show. Dropping, nigga. Talk gangster, but being caught with the cops, I do it for the ghetto. When the niggas on the towel line, the sharp and purple push got me sitting on cloud nine. I don't regret nothing. I got focused on the future, man. And the old school seeing life through my Gucci frames. Whatever don't kill you, make you stronger. That's a fact, dunny. All my niggas infatuated with getting crack money. Set the phone game up, stupid. I got the touch screen, my candy paint, mean money green in the gut cream. The game is super funny. Ain't been the same since Biggie died. Might see me getting high in the CL50. Don't wanna see me make it, they want me gone like the wind. So I'ma make classical music, that'll be my revenge. Niggas wanna take my life, but I won't let them. Tell them I got shots for them. Come get them, come get them, come get them, come get them. Yes, you can get it too if you run with them. Niggas wanna take my life, but I won't let them. Tell them I got shots for them, nigga, come get them. Come get them, come get them,
come get them, nigga.
Always went to class, but something in me changed right after my granddaddy passed. With my bottle, I need a swig. Ain't worried about these lame niggas that can't fuck with the kid. I'm fucking hoes doing shows, rolling bodies of Bali. How you sound? All my pounds came from Florida or Cali. My nigga Fire just came home, still on the streets. I try talking, but don't say much, cause I ain't the nigga to preach. We gotta get this dropping to nigga, it's time to get rich. Me and my niggas ran trains on her, life was a bitch. But niggas take cause they can't hold me down like Buffy and Mace. Only fuck with real if you fake. Get the fuck out my face. You fucking up my mojo cannon. I'm allergic to lanes. Twisted off a thug passion. Watch me serve in the range. I'm that next nigga. Believe I was born to prevail. They wanna see me in the pine. About to down in the jail. Oh, well. Niggas wanna take my life, but I won't let them. Tell them I got shots for them. Come get them. Come get them. Come get them. Come get them. Yes, you can get it too if you run with them. Niggas wanna take my life, but I won't let them. Soft when they hear them police bang. I'm on a dead end, putting it in with my hula gang. Niggas talk crazy like shit can't happen to them. Bird head ass nigga thinking I'm just rapping to them. Cut off the head and look at the body. I'm the shit, your style old like Mr. Miyagi. I done heard about the money that you put in the hood, but your shit is finna get shot, it won't do them no good. I got a couple low niggas direct. rap riding the fire. You never been a gangster, nigga, you just living a lie. You hear the pain in my vocals, cause my life is the truth. On some notorious B.I.G. shit, give me the loot. Man, I got niggas over in Europe that know about the click. I make these bitches fuck my homies while they stuck on my dick. You ain't saying nothing, fuck boy, you are a bird. That niggas pouring out looking for your ass on the curb. That's worse. Niggas wanna take my life, but I won't let them. Tell them I got shots for them. Come get him, come get him, come get him, come get him. Yes, you can get it too if you run with him. Niggas wanna take my life, but I won't let him. Tell him I got shots for him, nigga, come get him. Come get him, come get him, come get him. Yes, you can get it too if you run with him.
ODG, nigga. Fuck what you heard. You ain't running with me, you running from me, nigga. You know what I mean? That niggas act like I don't know that y'all niggas know I'm in the hood and run around these streets and all that. Come on, man, be for real, old head. ODG from now to the death, nigga. Wop.
Yeah. Screwball Radio live in the Matrix playing that bullshit like we always do. It's the J Hood Hour.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, live on Screwball
Radio.
What
you working on, man? Some new shit, man. I know niggas don't want to know what the hell you've been up to, Don.
Yeah, that's a fact, man. I just I just dropped this mixtape called Remember the Name Part 2, which is a sequel, obviously, to another, you know, mixtape series I got, Part 1. You know what I mean? It's basically, a mixtape of me back in my freestyle bag. You know what I mean? I took like mad nostalgic hip-hop beats, you know what I mean, and just did my thing over them, you know what I mean, Cool G rap beats, half a mil beats, you know what I mean, like different shit like that, and I'm just, you know, displaying,
small moves.
Lyricism and shit like that, because, you know, motherfuckers been telling me, like, yo, we need you back in your D-Block freestyle bag and all that, and I'm like, you know what, let me give it to them. So I just dropped those two tapes, they're available on Audio Mac, and I got an album called Pesci 4. That's out on all digital streaming platforms also. You know what I'm saying?
That's dope. That's dope, man. Since you bring up D-Block, man, you know, I'm a fan of this shit, man. And I got a question, man. I want to know, man, is there any possible way that y'all might can get, you know, certain things and come back and do something, man? Because I'm really a fan of this shit, and I'd love to see that shit, man. Word.
Yeah, it's love, it's love. Now, you know, I ain't even going to lie to you, man. Probably not. You know what I'm saying? It ain't nothing like... It ain't no real issues at all. Like, I wouldn't even say it's any issues, period. But, you know, the chances of that happening are, like, out of my hands. You feel me? Like, as far as me, I wouldn't be objective to that. But, you know, I can't control what the next man do or what they think. So I can't, like, really, you know, I can't call it. I'm, you know, I got love for Kiss. You know, I got respect for P and Luch as well. But, you know, I gotta be real. I don't see that happening, though. To be real with you.
That's real.
Just from my perspective, like, you know, to me, you know, when you was doing the mixtapes back in the day, like you was a beast. You know what I'm saying? And even still without them, you still a beast because you've been.
Right.
Doing your own thing. You've been, and ain't nothing changed. The bars are still gutter. You know what I'm saying? You still J Hood, and now you ODG. And, you know,
right.
You got to respect it. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, for me, being a fan also is, you know, I would love to hear an Alchemist J Hood album.
Bro.
Like, to me, you and J Hood, you on an Alchemist beat, on any Alchemist beat, it's just hip hop to me. It's
bro, on everything, right? Like, I can't like really recall who it was that asked me this, but I did an interview recently and they asked me like who would be my ideal producer to work with as far as like on the project, right? And for the longest, you know, that has been my pick. I'm like, yeah, me, a whole album producer. Like in full by Alchemist would be my, like, you know, dream album. I'm like, that would be so crazy. You feel what I'm saying? But, you know, unfortunately, yeah. I know, you know, the politics of the industry. You know what I'm saying? So that's kind of like what will prevent that from happening. I'm not going to say it would never happen, but that's, you know, that plays a big part in why it may not take place. But that would be like that would be crazy.
So I want to go back. You know, I want to go back. I want to go back because, you know, you came on the scene at a young age, right? How young were you when you started taking the music, like, seriously? Like, you know, because I think you were like 16 when you was running around with them, right?
Right.
So
on a serious level, I mean, I started rapping at like 10. I had an opportunity to be signed. Well, actually, I started rapping at like 9. I had an opportunity to be signed at like 11. But even at that point, I still didn't take it as serious as, you know, someone probably, you know, some people may have thought I did. But probably like around 14, 15, because when I first moved up top, I was supposed to sign with the Lost Boys before I even, you know, met the Locks and all that. So it was like around a little before then, you know, is when I like really realized, yo, I could really do something with this.
Yeah, because when you came out, to me, you was the hottest young, you know, because you was the hottest young spitting that shit. Like, you had people like A+, and you had all these other young artists that was out there,
mm-hmm.
you know, Sun NY, you know, a lot of these other guys, but they wasn't doing or spitting as hard as you was. And
right.
I know a lot of it contributed to that circle that was around you because it was nothing but heat. You know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
you were sitting down with them. You were sitting down with the Alchemists. You was doing, you know, you was all over the place. Even on the mixtape scene, like you was really, like the next up.
Yeah, to me, it was
you
a perfect
I mean?
Storm. You know what I'm saying? Because I was fortunate enough to, you know, like you said, to be around some cast that's looked at as some of the top lyricists in the game, well-respected individuals and all that, and still sharp and still. And I learned a lot from them. Just being around them was a blessing in itself because I was able to be a sponge and just intake so much information. And, you know, my whole mindset of how I write and the things that I come up with when I write, they, you know, have to credit them for a lot of that because, you know, they always told me, even on tracks with them, like, yeah, we want you to body us. We want you to be better than us. You know what I'm saying? That's how we want you to approach writing on every single song. And I just applied that, you know, to every verse I ever wrote. And, you know, until this day,
yeah,
I still
real.
Use it. So, yeah.
Because, you know, to go a little fast forward, you know, you did an album with West Coast legend Yuck Mouth.
For sure.
And you could tell that, you know, you came to body shit there. You know what I'm saying? Like I'll be listening.
Right.
You know, I'll be listening.
Yeah, because that's another thing too. People don't know Yuck spit. You feel me? So I ain't gonna lie to you. They might a lot of people might be sleeping on them over here on the East Coast. I'll be having to tell people like, yo, dog, when it comes to bars, Yuck got bars. So there was a few times on a few of those songs that I had to like redo my verse because I'm like, nah, it's a competitive sport. You know what I mean? A competitive art. So let me go back in and redo these bars because I can't have them doing me dirty like this or not. You feel me? But yeah.
Talk about being slept on, man. What you think about some of the guys missing in the hip hop 50-year anniversary thing? You know, a lot of people was upset about their favorite artists or certain people not being mentioned and shit. What you feel about that shit? Like, who
on
do
the
you
top
think 50? They not mentioned?
The top 50 greatest hip hop or greatest MC?
No, you know the 50 years hip hop. You know, a lot of people are mad at this guy.
I don't really know what to say. I mean, with these lists and all that, as far as the list goes, it's man, these
not the list, just the fact that
just the hip hop with the performances at
you know, like
Yankee Stadium and all
like,
that.
Like, yo, where's this guy? How come they don't got this guy? You know?
Yeah, I don't know what to really say about that. It's like I don't know, man. All the real students of hip hop know who needs to be acknowledged. And, you know, sometimes people, they don't mention everybody, man. It's a lot of pioneers that contributed to, you know, making the game what it is today. And unfortunately, everybody don't get accredited for it. You feel me? For whatever reason.
It's everybody. Like I want to see some Joe Love, and I want to see fucking certain niggas. Like, you know, you don't see too much of Zulu Nation presence and none of this shit. You know, it's like a lot of people, you know, but you can't get everybody, but at least get the right people.
Yeah, you know, and I guess that goes, the people who are in charge of these things, I guess, that kind of falls back on them, I think. You know what I'm saying?
True that.
I got another question for you, Hood. Who's an artist, like when you was younger and you was listening, even now to this day, who's an artist that's out there? He might be recording, he might not be recording, but someone that you looked at as a inspiration or like, you know, you looked up to them as, you know.
I'm going to tell you who I came up on. Okay? I mean, I don't. Hopefully that could, like, you know, that falls in the same category and that kind of answers the question. But when I came up, firstly, I listened to what my brother was listening to. My brother's older than me, you know what I mean? He got me about like 6-7 years, so he's the one who introduced me to hip hop. So in my household, you know, I was bumping what he was bumping, and I was all ears for whatever he was listening to. So I was listening to like Helter Skelter, you know, Boot Camp Click, of course Mobb Deep, you know, Wu-Tang, Goody Mob, Outkast, Ghetto Boys, you know, 8-Ball, MJG, Tribe Called Quest, you know what I'm saying? Like, shit like that. So, those are the groups I came up on, and that just made me want to enter the game and start doing this shit. Like, I'm like, yo, this shit dope, man. Let me try to see if I can start putting together rhymes and, you know, practice on this. And see what I could do, and that from there I just took a liking to this shit.
And as far as today, because you know a lot of
artists, Nas too, but yeah. Like Nas and you know the greats and shit. I can't leave them out, but you know.
What about the new artists out there now? How you feel like the state of hip hop and where it's at right now compared to when you was coming up and running around?
The current state of hip hop, I think. I think hip hop is in a space, obviously, where, you know, the artists are able to generate more revenue easily. You know what I'm saying? And they're in a position where they could be in control of their careers more than they was, you know, when I was coming up, and they could, you know, they have more outlets. You know what I'm saying? That they could do certain shit from, and it has its pros and its cons, because, you know, the pros are exactly what I was saying. It's like you could make all of this money. You don't need labels. You could put yourself out there, you know, but just by doing the right things and having social media and having computers and, you know, things of that nature. But the cons are anybody could do it. Like, you know what I'm saying? The chances of you just slipping through the cracks are high. Like back in the days, you at least had to possess a certain level of skill to obtain a certain level of notoriety. Like nowadays, you could be completely garbage and throw out a song with a melodic hook and like a bassy beat, and you may get lucky and make it. You feel what I'm saying? Just off the strength of social media or going viral or something like that. So it's like, it's kind of kind of like a funny space.
That's the money side of it, but I'm talking about like who's some artist now that you actually think like, damn, they hot. Like for me, you know, like everybody that's listening to hip hop, you know, they're gonna go to Buffalo and they're gonna give it to Griselda, you know, because Griselda came at a time where all that mumble shit was going on, you know, and they were able to stand out from the mumble shit.
Okay.
So who's some?
Yeah,
people...
I was looking at the you know, the whole game is in its totality and all that, but as far as people that I think are the, you know, doing their thing right now, that I, you know, will tip my hat to. I mean, obviously them, like Conway, Benny and them. My dude RJ Payne. By the way, me and him got some a couple of joints about to drop, so be on the lookout for them. You know, cats like Rock Marciano. You know, it's a bunch of dope cats in the real underground hip hop pocket that are consistent, that's keeping lyricism alive. You know what I'm saying? They're just not mainstream. So it's like it's a bunch of dudes. You got new dudes like the Steve God Cooks guy, like, you know what I'm saying? You got 38 Special. You feel me? You got a lot of dudes, man.
And we got Jay Hood. You heard?
Oh yeah, definitely.
Jay
absolutely.
Jay Hood Radio. Even hit some more. Fuck, I need some more Jay Hood in my life, man. You crazy? It's fucking the weekend, man. Let's go. Word is bone.
Oh, for sure, man. We own it, man. We own it, man. And call number 516-531-9556. Anybody want to join in and chop it up with us? We got Jay Hood on the line. Got a dope deal. And let's get on with it.
Let's get it.
Who am?
Nigga, man, fuck Jay Hood too. Nigga, that nigga's a mark too. Nigga, now you rocking with yucky shit. Nigga, what kind of shit is that? I mean, nigga, I'm out here really getting it. Nigga, I'm in these streets. These old fake ass industry ass niggas, man. Fuck them niggas, man. I'm everything, nigga. Fuck that, nigga.
Savage. Yo, I lay this shit banging, fool. Yo, yeah, what's shaking, big homie?
What's happening, nigga?
Yada!
Yada!
S-A-V-A-G-E-S. Big Butch Master on me when I'm out in the West.
No, we got it.
Try to run down on me, you getting clipped. Every single nigga that you see me with is with the shit. S-A-V-A-G-E-S. Big Butch Master on me when I'm out in the West.
Automatic.
Try to run down on me, you getting clipped. Every single nigga that you see me with is with the shit.
Every nigga with me dragging tatty. Matching like assassins. Lashing niggas for that ration. Niggas felt that action. They shout, got a Woodstock. This ain't camp at 50 shots. Make a nigga pop cocky, break dance. I'm a savage for that paper. My goonies pulling up, busting cannons out the scraper. Go bananas with the cater. Knock him down like flavor. That nigga clocked out. I never made a statement in life. I never copped out. With the paperwork on them cases you niggas talk about. The same nigga hating, still faking and getting knocked out. Niggas doing live from the house. You gotta hide out. I'm red carpet LA live with all the ice out. It's ice mouth, goddamn it, just spell the name right. You won't bust a grape, we bring bananas to the eight fight. You guppy niggas fucking with a great white, with the mind of Frank White. You niggas chatty patties, get your cake right, boy.
S-A-V-A-G-E-S. Big Butch Master on me when I'm out in the West.
No, we got it.
Try to run down on me, you getting clipped. Every single nigga that you see me with the shit. S-A-V-A-G-E-S. Big Butch Master on me when I'm out in the West. Try to run down on me, you getting clipped. Every single nigga that you see me with the shit.
S-A-V-A-G-E-S. I'm a motherfucking savage, bitch, nigga, oh yes. Niggas out here playing with me, but I'm not to be toyed with. Waffle whip with the beam, I'm letting the phone spit. Hood like Rodney, but I
I'm short like Pesci. Wintertime, I'm inked up. Warm as fuck with the Desi. I ride on a nigga, treat his ass like heroin. Always been small, but I'm one of the terrorists. I'm gully like Young, out here buzzing like Lil Baby. Got cocksucking non-rapping niggas that won't spray me. So I'm gripped up, homie, like the balls on a motorcycle. Indoor bar drinking scotch with a loaded rifle. I told Yuck if you smoke, then where the light at? All he gotta do is point him out and I'm a llama cat. One mob, I thought I told you how we rock. Ain't got time to squabble, no safety, I'm letting it pop. Burning on some goji, these rappers is so phony. Talking all this gangster shit, but they so corny. Never ever told how many of y'all can say the same. A lot of niggas got firearms with zero aim. S-A-V-A-G-E-S. Big rich master on me when I'm out in the west. Try to run down on me, you getting clipped. Every single nigga that you see me with is with the shit. S-A-V-A-G-E-S. Big butch master on me when I'm out in the west. Try to run down on me, you getting clipped. Every single nigga that you see me with is with the shit.
One of my favorite joints, new joints of yours, man. The whole vibe, the whole That's just crazy to me.
Yeah, my God, twin, man. Yeah, man. Me and them got some shit.
Yeah, smooth
yeah,
on
man,
that, man.
Yeah, that shit was all smooth right there, man. That shit, all New York, that shit sound like New York. Like one thing for sure, you know, all your records sound New York. You know what I mean? Don't matter if you in L.A., it still sound New York. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for sure, man. Try to keep it real, real up top, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know we coming to the, but we want to extend this episode a little bit if you with it. You know what I'm saying? Because you know I still got questions. You know, I know you got a couple projects coming. I know you've
for
been
sure.
working a lot. You know what I'm saying? So, you know. Not too long ago, I went to a mega show, and I was able to see Shyheim, the Rugged Child,
mm-hmm.
and you guys are supposed to be working on the album.
Right.
And I know y'all dropped the video, but where's the rest of it? You know what I'm saying? Is it finished?
Right,
is
right.
it on the way?
Yeah, see, you know, I'm gonna tell you something, right? I ain't gonna really get too in detail with it, but you know, obviously, like you said, we got this album that was on the way. We dropped a single called "Get Back." I did the interview on Math Hopper. I brought Shyheim with me. We got to knock out some of the video at the interview. You know what I mean? Threw the joint up on on YouTube, whatever the case be. Got a lot of views. You know, we was working on an album. We got to about like 7 tracks, and it was just so much going on, or so many things took place after that interview came out. You know, things just start spiraling in a certain direction, and it just, you know, a bunch of people start coming out the woodworks. I guess a lot of people that wasn't too fond of him, and then you know, a lot of people, you know, start speaking on me. You got the reactions, I mean, the responses from SP, Cheek, and all this other type of stuff. So it's like, I guess it might have put him in a situation, a sticky situation, might I say. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, that kind of prolonged everything, and it, like, took the momentum away from what we had going on. So it kind of, like, you know, we pushed the album to the back burner, because it was just a lot that happened with all that. And, you know, I can't really, besides that, I can't really say what happened. But as of right now, it's like the album is on the back burner.
Right. Well, one thing, Jay Hood, and I just want to let you know, my nigga, man, you got to control the narrative, man. You know what I'm saying? Don't let nobody else control y'all guys' narrative, man. And you know what I'm saying? Because I know it's hard. A lot of haters come out of nowhere, a lot of talk. But you control
right.
the narrative, man. You know what I'm saying? And don't let the motherfuckers stop you in your moves.
For sure, for sure. Absolutely.
Yeah, on top of that, you brought up a big factor about this blackballing thing. So people be thinking blackballing ain't really like a label telling you, like a label telling people, oh, you can't work with this person. It's more so with the monkey see, monkey do, but then the business. It's more so with the peer group. Like one person can be like, oh, I don't want him to work with that person. And everybody just follows suit.
First of all, E, you sound like you got your head in the toilet. Second of all, E, last time when you went off and shit, we had some dead space, man. Don't let that happen again, especially when we got guests
good.
Here. You heard we got guests here. We don't need you doing no dumb shit, yeah? All right? No yellow M&M moments, man. Be on
your
best behavior.
Point, man.
You got Jay Hood in the house. All right, I just want to let you know that. No more dead air, no more space. We got to keep this shit rolling. Continue.
For sure, for sure.
Word. And another question I got, you know, being that, you know, you did the Infamous in the Hood with Twin, and I know
mm-hmm.
that was a great project. Would there ever be a part two?
You know, it's ill. We were supposed to work on the part two a while ago, but... you know, things that, you know, he was doing a lot and I was doing a lot myself and all that, so we didn't get to really get started on it, but it was supposed to be completely produced by Ito. You know what I'm saying? And I just spoke to Etho a couple days ago, and he asked me about that too. That's what's so funny about you bringing that up. He's like, whatever happened to that? And I told him basically what I just told you. But me and Etho about to start a project also. You know, he's going to totally produce a new EP that I'm about to start working on. So, but as far as the twin thing, we gonna get it cooked up because that's my guy. We got like great chemistry.
Yeah, I was gonna say y'all sound great together because you know y'all got that, you know y'all got that YOQB connection,
right.
Shit, you know what I'm saying? Like y'all just sound great together. And I was at the
you can't front on our joint, you know, because we rock with the great J Hood too. You know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah,
yeah,
yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
All three of us. That's a
and
fact.
That was crazy. So
you know, I just know about that too. Yeah, you're right. But I ain't wanna bring us into his what he got going on right now. You know what I'm saying? Like I wasn't thinking that way. But I was at the album release party with Doo Wop and all that, and I saw you on that album, you know, you did your thing on that album.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah,
and I just like the fact
Yeah,
for sure. You know, you already on Pesci 4, you know what I'm saying? And you just been, you know, quote unquote, on the grind, you know, on the grind for all this time.
That's a fact, man. You know, new project on the way called Doughboy's Revenge. You know what I'm saying? New EP, totally produced by my dude. Keep an eye on the product. So that's in the works. That's dropping at some point this month. You know what I'm saying? So be on the lookout for that.
What is ODG also releasing? Like as far as like. You got artists on the roster.
We got Stickman. Stickman, he's dropping stuff sporadically. He got this project called King David that we're preparing right now, which is more so it's a dancehall album because you know he's Jamaican, so we wanted to like somewhat step outside of the box of what people you know are used to us you know giving them, and we want to cater to the island people. You know what I mean? Because he got songs that are big vibes that could potentially,
right.
You know, catch fire internationally and all that. So we want to try to push him in that direction. So
you know, we got your back. We're going to support you no matter what you do over here. We're going to support you. We got your back for life over here at Screwball Radio. You
for sure. Love.
Yeah, we definitely always, anytime you drop, we definitely always play it. You know, one of my big records of yours, you know, that I've been playing since you dropped it is What If. You know,
okay.
That's another,
yes, sir.
Another joint you dropped that I think is, you know, is monumental, man. Like, and, you know, to me it should get more shine because you're talking real shit on it. You know what I mean?
Right. You know, it's the politics of the game, man. You know what I'm saying? It's, you know what it is. But,
yeah,
you know,
definitely
you gotta,
the politics.
We're going to keep pushing. We'll keep pushing.
A hard record is a hard record, and, you know, you got loyal fans. You know what I mean?
So right. So that's my thing, right? That's my whole shit. That's why, like, you know, people be like, yo. See, this is what people don't understand. And people like us, we understand, like, what's going on as far as, like, with the pocket of hip-hop that we in. People like, yo. You should try to do this, try to do that, and try to go mainstream. I'm like, yo, bro, everybody don't want to go mainstream. You feel what I'm saying? Like, some people just want to cater to their fans and their loyal base. And, of course, you want your base to grow and all that. But everybody's aim isn't to go mainstream.
I don't even know how to go mainstream. Like, how do you go in a fucking studio and say, I'm going to make a mainstream record? You just bang out. You don't know where it's going to fucking land.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? He's like, yo, I don't know, man. Niggas is crazy. Just got to do you, man. Let this shit fall where it fall.
Exactly. You know what I mean? Make music for the people. You know, the way I look at it, man, I just go in there and work, and the people appreciate it. It's going to land on the ears of the people who appreciate it, and they're going to support it. You know what I'm saying? The people that don't support it, it ain't for them.
Right.
Yeah, for real.
Anything
you know,
can be mainstream. Like, our underground shit that we do, it could be mainstream if it was played on the mainstream more. You know what
I'm
saying? So I don't think it's a certain type.
I mean, it was
about what they choose to push.
I mean, our music was mainstream at one time. before the controlling. You know,
absolutely.
Because there was a time that all you heard on the radio was the mob, Buck, you know, Boot Camp Click, and you know the Freddie Foxes, the Kool G Raps. You know, like there was a time where all that was on the radio. That was normal, and it just came later. And like you say, the politics and the controlling and the money under the table and you know. Play this music 1,000 times. Don't shed no light. But you know, what we also don't have anymore is like Future Flavors and you know the Stretch and Bobbito shows and you know all the shows that catered
Stretch Armstrongs and all that.
Yeah, you know, like
this is the thing.
None of those
contrary
shows.
To a lot of people's beliefs, man. Because, you know, everybody has...
Like niggas used to be tuned in to Mr. Magic back in the day when to hear world, premiere.
Oh, man. You heard that, you knew you was about to hear some exclusive.
You know what I'm saying? That's what shit is missing, like the groundbreakers, the record breakers.
Right. Everybody's caught up on this new wave, the new age sound and all that. But, you know, the contrary to a lot of people's belief, and it's mainly because a lot of people haven't been fortunate enough to travel outside of the States, but hip-hop is so huge internationally, like, on a level, I'm talking about, like, people really appreciate real bars and real underground hip-hop in all these different countries. You feel what I'm saying? So it's like you said, the records and the type of music that we make, it really could be way bigger than what it is right now if it was to reach and land on all the ears that it could potentially land on. You know what I'm saying? But, you know.
Yeah, like for me, you know, my fan base, you know, overseas, you know, they love us overseas.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like over there, France, Germany, you know, they always looking for that next Blaq Paul record. They always looking for my next record. Like, if I could get that love over there, over here, who knows?
I know that they wild over there right now. I've seen the kid jump on stage like Kane was fucking rapping.
Oh, yeah, because he was tight that he got bumped off the bill for a United States artist. But, you know, Kane ain't just some United States artist. He's a legend. He's a legend in the game. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you got to give respect to the founding artist, man.
That's hip hop royalty, man.
These days, niggas is real sensitive these days, man.
Right, definitely.
Yeah, because they let the internet and the buzz that the internet gives them some kind of hierarchy. Meanwhile, if there was no internet, would you be that? Because Kane was that before there was internet. You know what I mean? Like Paul, like Hood, like. Like, y'all had names before the internet was even anything, before you could even go viral. Even the word viral didn't mean nothing.
Right.
You know, y'all...
Man,
y'all
Kane, like, for anybody that don't acknowledge Kane and don't know how he's viewed or how he should be looked at, like, they don't even deserve a place in hip-hop. That's hip-hop royalty, man. That's one of the, you know, the forefathers. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's like a no-brainer.
Yeah, for real. Like, if you in hip hop and ain't giving Kane his respect, you're not really hip hop.
For real.
Before I even started thinking about doing music, that's who I was listening to: Big Daddy Kane and the Bismarckies and you know,
Kool G Raps and all that. You know,
yeah,
I mean?
Kool G Rap, Curious George, you know, Showbiz and AG, you know. I could keep going. Poet, Blaq Poet, you know, the Tragedy Gaddafis. Like, I could just keep going. Like, these are all people that I looked up to as a youngin' listening to hip hop. And to go on stage and disrespect somebody like that, you know, he lucky he Kane wasn't younger. He probably would have got stomped out.
Yeah, when I seen, you know? I seen homeboy on stage, yeah, I'm like, yo, what the nerve of these dudes.
Straight disrespectful.
The kids isn't matter nobody, you know. Motherfucker got no name out there. They go by Hijack. You know, they got a nice little following out there. But, you know, they could handle it a different way. But I think, you know what I'm saying, Kane and him, cause, you know, it ain't even nobody's fault, man. It just, shit happens, man. That's all.
Yeah.
I mean, technically, you know, whoever's running the stage should have not let him walk on the stage like that. Like, it should have been better.
If Kane wanted to, he could have just ended the show right there, get his money and go, and tell his promoter, yo, we better fucking have better security next time. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And let this guy go ahead and perform, and he have an early show, he have an early night, and the crowd would have been mad at the kid, let the crowd get mad at him. Like, you know what? I'm leaving here. Boom, boom, boom. Talk to the promoter. Get his money and leave. Because they can't keep motherfuckers off the stage. You know, let the crowd handle it. Like, yo, what you doing, man? You know, Kane didn't, it was, you know, a lot of people would have said, you know, a lot of people would handle it different ways, man. It's different ways to handle everything,
right,
man. Kane was ready to fight.
I'm going to ask both of y'all, Hood and Poet, how would y'all feel if y'all on stage performing and some random just come up on your stage? What would you do?
That motherfucker did that to me. I'm out there and fucking, I forgot where I was at. I was performing and shit. Motherfucker kept fucking wanting to get on stage, hop on stage, making noise on the side. I stopped my show. I told the motherfucker, yo, you spit. Get on stage. Come up here on stage. Gave him the mic. Told him to get busy, and he didn't say shit. I took the mic, told him to get the fuck out of here, gave him a fucking cup of Hennessy, and continued going. The whole crowd was laughing at that motherfucker. So sometimes you got to, you know, rock with niggas, man. Let niggas do it, but, you know, it's a way to handle shit, man. Different niggas do it different ways, man. But Kane was ready to fight.
Yeah, facts. I mean, it depends.
How you handle that shit, Hood?
It depends how, you know, they approach. If they just try to, you know, jump on stage on some bow garden type shit.
No, same scenario with Kane, but it's just you. How would you have treated that?
See, the way I probably would have did it, to tell you the truth, I ain't gonna front. He was standing in front of Kane like that. I probably would have came behind
him. I
would have
pushed him off stage. I ain't gonna
crowd. I probably would have kicked him into the crowd from behind because he
kicked
right
him in his ass or something,
stage,
man.
I probably the Timberland would have out of dress kicked that nigga into the crowd, probably. he was standing right there, like in front of me. I was like, "Oh shit, boom!"
Yeah, he would have been stage diving. I mean, crowd surfing and all.
But then you got to remember, you in the nigga's hood, so. You know what I'm saying? You got to get back to the hotel. You got to go back to the fucking lot. You get a lot of things, man. You got to be ready to...
Yeah, that's true. There's a lot of shit to consider. That's a fact. But,
you know.
You know
what I'm saying? But, yeah, he probably didn't met Timberland. He probably met Mr. Timberland in his back. He didn't know that shit again. But it all depends on how I felt at the moment. Probably would have kicked him in his back into this fucking... to the crowd. Or probably would have let him rock. What's the problem, my man? You want to get on here? Oh, I probably would have left, got my money early. It's an early night. Let the crowd fucking tear up the club because I'm leaving.
Right, yeah. And then that's a situation where you got to, like, look at the promoter also. Like, yo, bro, what my security? You supposed to secure the stage? Like, what's up with my safety? You feel me? You letting some nondescript nigga jump on the joint while I'm here? You feel me? Like,
yeah, King could have had an early night.
Right.
Yeah,
did he continue
performing
after that?
I don't know. I didn't see the rest of that footage. I just see where he was taking his jacket off, about to, you know, start dumping with him. But
right when he took that jacket off, that's when you know, like, yeah, he to that point, like, yeah,
it's going down.
Yeah, Kane shouldn't even be having to take his jacket off, though. You feel me?
For real.
Yeah.
For real.
Yeah.
They should.
But he could have got the crowd to flip on him and be like, you know what, I'm out of here. Niggas ain't got no respect. Peace, y'all.
Right.
Get money and get the fuck out of here. Let the crowd.
Blame it on him.
Yeah. And still get his money and the promoter can't say nothing. I'm out of here.
Be like, yo, if y'all don't handle this dude and get him up out of here, I ain't performing. I'm stopping my shit right here and we gonna call it a night.
And that'd have been it. Seriously. The crowd would have been crazy.
Yeah, here's one question me and Troy always ask, you know, I guess, how you feel about the verses and, you know, they're not going off top, everything is song for song, and how would you do a verses?
I'm glad you asked me that, right, because I presented the idea on my on my vlog series on YouTube a couple of months ago, right? That kind of pertains to that. What I basically came up with an idea, and I think Blaq would probably, he would have been the perfect person to execute this because he has the, you know, the connection and the power to do it. But I suggested that they come up with something with a similar concept as verses, but they call it like the bar exam, right? And you have like a flex and like one of those hip hop attorneys that be commenting on everything that happens within the hip hop world as far as like with people catching cases and stuff like that. You have them hosted, and then you have two elite MCs come in and give them a chance to spit three verses. Three hard 16s or 324s, and then you bring in a well-known hip-hop producer and let them create the track or the tracks that the artists use. You know what I'm saying? And one of my lineups that I had was Kiss versus Blaq Thought. You let Alchemist do the beats for it. You know what I mean? Then you have somebody come in like a Freddie Gibbs versus like a what's the homie name? I forgot right now, but yeah, you know, something like that. Like that type of concept.
That's dope. I mean, you know, like me and Paul, we always talking like the verses should have been like instead of a song for song, like an actual battle, like rhyme for rhyme. You know, not so much like
everybody can't spit like that though. You know what I'm saying? That's the only thing with that.
I mean,
you call me
loud.
That's what Jada did.
Nah, but see, that's the thing too. Everybody, all those artists that be on the verses aren't MCs. You know what I mean? These are just artists. They're songwriters and shit like that. So,
well, they shouldn't be the ass up on there talking about the battle of the band. That's the battle of the bands.
You know, like they're getting 50s and shit.
Yeah, because, you know, Kiss did scrape Dipset. They single-handedly
You want to be honest. You feel me?
Yeah,
like, he dismantled him. He hijacked the whole thing. He bought them. He hijacked the show and took it from making it about the hits to the bars. You know what I mean? Like, I'm going to take them out their element, and we're going to go straight to these lyrics and all that. I'm going to take you to the mixtape element of this.
Yeah, for real. And it damn sure worked.
Facts.
Damn sure worked, for real.
I thought it was going to be more of a battle than what it was. I'm like, man, you know, they got bangers. They got, like, anthems and shit like that, so it ain't going to be no easy win. But soon as Kiss flipped the script and took it to that, it was over. It was like, yo, like the Rocky fight with Adrian on the side, like, you can't win. I'm like, God damn, he hooking off. He uppercutting him. He jabbing him by himself. You know what I mean? Like, P and Luce, they was, you know, they on the side, but Kiss was just, Kiss did his numbers.
Yeah, he came to play. He came to play, for sure. He was not playing with them.
Mm-hmm.
But that was an ill, you know, Swiss and Timberland coming up with that whole idea, that whole concept. That was dope. But, you know, like the first one with
Kamea and RZA. That was really effective, though. Verses, I meant to say.
I mean, a lot of the ones after that wasn't so much. You know what I'm saying? You had Bone Thugs. You had Homegirl Calling Gangsta Boo, like some crackhead kind of shit. And
36 Mafia.
You know, that whole verses was like, you know, I wasn't feeling that versus. Ain't nothing like the Dipset versus. Ain't nothing like the Premier versus RZA versus. You know, those two are the best ones to me.
Right.
You know, you had your kid.
Kane and Chris.
Who?
Was that?
Big Daddy Kane and KRS. That was a dope one.
That was all right, man. But it wasn't. Basically, wasn't not no, you know, Madison Square Garden. The Garden one was the best one. Blaq and Dipset, that was the best and biggest one.
Yeah, no, that's a fact. You know? You had to join with Jeezy and Gucci.
That was,
you know,
disrespectful.
It's been dope, like, a lot of them didn't have a crowd because of the COVID shit. Kissing them shit was also dope because of the crowd.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you're right.
Snoop and DMX one, that would have been crazy. Imagine that crowd, the two dogs. Oh my God.
Yeah,
that
would have been silly. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you know, let's give the people some more music before we get up out of here. You know,
for
let
sure.
The people know, you know, what you got going on, what you got up
and
coming.
New EP dropping, man. Doughboy's Revenge. You know what I'm saying? I'll be out later this month. If you ain't heard,
any
shows? Just, you know, tuning in. Doughboy, like Doughboy from Boys in the Hood, Doughboy's Revenge, man. You know what I'm saying? For those that are just tuning in right now, we were talking about the Remember the Name Part 2 mixtape that's available on Audio Mac exclusively, so go check that out. All banging freestyles, you know what I mean? Real nostalgic hip-hop beats, straight bars. Volume 1 is available also. Pesci Part 4 is out on all distributed. Excuse me, on all streaming platforms. You know, run me up. Go check out my YouTube. My vlog series is on there. We'll show your boy some love, man. We got a lot of music.
Any
about
shows?
To drop.
Any shows coming up?
We're trying to set a little a winter tour up right now. Ain't nothing solid, but you know, as we get more information on it, I'm gonna let you know. And me and Yuck Mouth, we basically done with Savages Part 2. Also, so I'll keep y'all updated on that.
All right. Do you have physical copies?
Screwball Radio, man.
You know, you got physical copies for the fans, or you strictly with the streaming? Because, you know, for me, I use streaming, but I'm truly against streaming because I feel like it take away from us artists.
Right. Yeah, I normally have physical copies of all the projects that I drop, but like as of right now, I don't have none on deck, but for this Doughboy's Revenge EP, I'm definitely pressing up a few. So, you know, for everybody that's following me,
where they can order that from when it does become available.
Yeah, you can order them directly from me, my website. It's my site is down right now, but it'll be back up this week. But once it's back up, you can check that out. And it will be up on my all my social media accounts for everybody that don't follow me, man. Follow me on Instagram @RealJHood_ or Twitter @RealJHood. You know what I'm saying? And definitely keep everybody updated.
How you feel about the change? You just mentioned Twitter, but it's called X now.
Oh yeah, definitely. My fault. X. The X, the app formerly known as Twitter.
For real.
I mean, I'll still be on it. You know what I'm saying? Because I conduct a lot of business off of that app. I really thought that it was about to be obsolete because of the whole Threads thing, because when Threads first popped off, it was like skyrocketing and everybody was on it, but slowly but surely it started to decline. So,
right.
You know, I kind of went back
to
X.
What I can understand is that it's just the same people on all these apps. It's like, it's not like it's new people coming in.
Right.
It's all the same people, yo. What the fuck?
Facts.
It's crazy.
Now, you know what I mean? It's because Elon, people was kind of like excited to switch over to another app because of all the stuff that Elon was doing with Twitter. You know what I mean? Like he was putting like, he only gives people a certain amount of characters in there, you know, their tweets. You can only view a certain amount of tweets every day. Like he's doing all these stupid type of tweaks to the app.
You
got like, paid. Man, come on, bro.
Because he's trying to make
chat.
A dollar off of it.
Yeah,
trying to make money off the people instead of the advertisers. You know, you're trying to get right. That's how you. That's why you're a billionaire. You don't forget you're a billionaire. You're a billionaire. You're trying to get money over every angle.
Yeah, no, that's a fact. That's a super fact. Super duper fact.
Take a shot
in
here.
Thank you for coming through, man.
Screwball Radio, yo. You already know it's love, man. Anytime, all the time. Definitely appreciate y'all, man. You already know.
Yeah, you always 100.
For sure, man.
That's why we show love to you all the time. And like I said, anytime you dropping something, you know, our ears to the street, you can just send it to us and we're going to rock it.
For sure. Yeah, my man, before we get up out of here, one more question. I remember I had to ask y'all this because it was intriguing to me, and I was tuned in all day. I don't know how big you guys are into sports, or if you're even into sports at all.
Yeah, we do sports.
Oh, yeah,
but,
Man, I don't know if y'all checked out, because, you know, Deion Sanders, Coach Prime, he over there in Colorado right now, you know what I mean? Man. If y'all, I don't know if y'all checked out that game earlier, Colorado versus TCU, but them boys came out ready to play. Shador Sanders threw for 510 yards, had 4 or 5 touchdowns, no interceptions. It was a hell of a game.
Oh, yeah, Coach Prime got them boys on some bullshit.
Facts.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You know, the other team was mad that he left to go over there, too, you know. So, you know, he just took his talent somewhere else. And, you know, the kids is ready to play for him. They happy he's there. And it's just showing, you know.
That's
ain't nothing better. Ain't nothing better than having a coach to play for that you want to play for. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
You're going to come to play. You're going to come to play.
Like you said, it shows. They ready to run through a wall for Coach Prime. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
for real.
Yeah,
I mean, it's like,
open. And that's the new team that he went and took over. Yeah. He got the boys open.
Man, Travis Hunter had like, what he had like? He had an interception. He had like 100. Matter of fact, they broke a record today. Man, they had 4 receivers with over 100 yards. Travis Hunter playing offense and defense. He had an interception. He had 10 receptions. He played 127 snaps on both offense and defense. It was crazy.
Tell me something.
Yeah,
are they going to ever meet up, those two teams? Is old team and the new team, do they meet up?
Nah, because the old team is in a SWAC conference, and this one is in a whole other conference. This is like a bigger Power 12.
Okay. That'd be hell.
Yeah, they're like in the SEC, right? The SEC or something like that?
Right. It's a Pac-12 division.
That'd have been interesting.
So it's like it's
see.
On a bigger level. You know what I mean? They playing bigger schools
more,
and all that.
One more question before you get out of here. I know you a Laker fan.
Mm-hmm.
No, I know. How
we
you
got
feel
LeBron
about
Hayden, what's going on
season, how you feel about their season last year and where you think they're going to be at this year?
I was satisfied with the season last year, you know, with all things being considered, man. You know, they brought in a bunch of new people towards the end of the season, and they turned the whole season around from being like an 11th, 13th seed to a 7th seed to being in a Western Conference Finals. You know what I'm saying? So that was an improvement in itself. But, you know, I was a little disappointed at the fact that they got swept and they wasn't able to get a win. And, you know, mainly because I'm going to put some of that on the coach as far as, like, his lineups and all that and his inability to, you know, to switch up his end-game adjustments and stuff like that and a couple people not showing up. But they just added a couple of new pieces to the roster that I think is going to do it justice. You feel me? So now it's a more complete team. They got more time to gel. You know what I'm saying? More time to get the chemistry together. And I think
LeBron
got to
step it up, man. Bottom line, LeBron got to step it up.
You said
LeBron
got to step it
up? No, the Brow.
Oh, the Brow. Oh, yeah. There you go. AD, man, he's like – that was another problem last year. AD was inconsistent. You know what I'm saying? One day he might give you 20 and 28. You know what I'm saying? The next day he might give you 11 and 15 or something, like, you know what I mean? And the next day he might give you 17 points, 8 rebounds. Like, yo, bro, you got to you got to be that beast that you know you could be consistently. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, you got to be more consistent, man.
You got to take some of the pressure off Bron, man, because Bron will be 39, 21st season. He can't, like, be carrying the whole team on his back. And you know what I mean? That's just,
that,
like, unrealistic.
For real. And Giannis, I heard Giannis is thinking about getting traded.
Yeah, I mean,
yeah,
that man want to win, man. He like, look, everybody over here is getting ready. You know, they getting older, and I ain't trying to be part of no rebuild. You feel me?
What they do with Damian?
Damian Lillard? They should do with Damian Lillard.
You know, he's trying to. I don't know if they're going to actually get him to Miami. You know, he's really pushing for that. I don't know if it's going to happen, but if it does happen, it's going to be a very interesting move, and it's going to shake the league up. But I don't know. I don't know if they're going to do it for him, though, because, I mean, they should, because he's been more than loyal to them over the years. He could have been dipped out. You know what I'm saying? Like,
they waited too long. They waited too long because now he's older, and now they
right.
You're not going to get what you're worth, but he's worth from nobody. Nobody's going to give up the whole squad for him.
That's exactly what they was just saying a couple of days ago. They like, yo, look, man, he's older. He might be a little injury prone. We're not about to give you all these assets and these pieces for him. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, don't wait too long to bust a move, so you might have to stay over there.
Yeah, I got one for both of y'all. I got one for both of y'all. What if Giannis and Lillard was to come to New York?
Oh, you see me fucking running up.
Oh,
and
you wishing upon a star now.
Naked.
Okay.
I'll be a happy camper.
I'm just saying, what if? Like your record, what if Lillard
and
Giannis?
Would you play the wish upon a star game?
I'll be a happy camper. I swear to God, yo. I'll be the fucking happiest motherfucker.
Yeah, that'll be lit. That'll light the city up.
You know who's an asshole? You know who's a team fucker? Yeah, there's two niggas out there that be fucking up the teams they go. That nigga James Harden and fucking Kyrie. A lot of niggas always fucking up the squad, man.
You think Kyrie
Kyrie, I be feeling like he plays selfishly, like he don't really be for a team, like it be about him. You know, last time he really played for a team was when he was on Cleveland and there was no LeBron there and he was the man, you know?
But they wasn't winning nothing, though.
Nah, they weren't winning, but, you know, they went to the playoffs without LeBron being there, but then they won with LeBron being there, which was, you know, a good look for Kyrie. But,
you know, not to regurgitate shit that's always being said, but, man, he ain't won nothing since he was with Bron, you know what I mean? And it's like, I think he severed that connection prematurely, you know what I mean? Because they had a dope chemistry together, you feel me?
Yeah, for real.
Yeah. He's not a 1A player.
What about son? Yo, E, what was that guy that said that he looked at how he was playing and he's going to come back this year and play hard? What's his name? He was on the Sixers and they traded him to the Nets.
Oh, Ben Simmons?
Ben Simmons.
Oh, God.
Man.
He's a turd.
He's talking about he's going to come this year and he's going to play better.
He's more.
And he's going to do what he
I make you say that shit every year, man.
I think he's a straight dud.
He's definitely a straight dud.
I think he's a straight dud.
He's one of them blanks that be in the gun. You load it up, you think that shit about to fire crazy, you shoot it, don't nothing come out. It's just a bang.
Oh, he has starter pistol.
Facts.
What about your NFL prediction? What you think about the NFL and who's your team and what you looking for from your team?
I'm not going to lie to you. I'm going to keep it all the way a rack, man. Like, normally, I haven't really had a team since they let my dude Cam Newton go because that's my favorite player and all that, you know what I'm saying? But I think this year I'm going to roll with Buffalo, man, because Josh Allen, and he got a good team around him. And they pretty good. So I think I might roll with them.
Can't front on the Eagles. Can't front on the G-Men. You better not front on my Jets. Cause you got the bad man.
Now y'all niggas got Brett Favre, and now y'all can't front on the Jets. Come on, bro.
All right, we gonna see.
That nigga was screaming on Jets. That nigga screaming Jets.
We gonna see.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I think Brett Favre might change the landscape of the Jets. We'll see what happens though.
Oh yeah, I'm definitely gonna call you when we start busting ass. I'm gonna give you. Remember you said? Remember what you
no
said?
No doubt. So you think
they're going to
make the playoffs?
They should. I think they should. I think they look good. I think they're going to do better than they've been. I mean, you know, last time they didn't really do shit.
Dunnie, the defense and a good O-line.
Yeah.
And he got good receivers.
Yeah, like you said, they should do something.
It's going to be an interesting football season. I'm looking forward to it.
I tell you what, though,
man.
You can't front on that boy. What's the homie name, man, from the Bengals, man?
Joe
Burrow, man. Cool Joe, man. You can't front on Joe, and Mahomes is always going to be there, too. So it's like those are the.
Yeah, I like Joe, man. I like Joe. I really like the Eagles, man. I really like the Eagles, too, man. It's a lot of squads, man, that I really like, man. And I want to see something happen.
Jalen Hurts, Patrick Mahomes, and Joe Burrow, those are like the three. I think they probably got the highest ceilings.
What about Baltimore?
Lamar and
with the homie. Lamar got Odell Beckham now.
And another nigga, he got somebody else too.
Yeah,
it's gonna be a fun year of football.
Too bad
ESPN ain't on fucking Spectrum no more. We gonna have to find our football if you got Spectrum, nigga, because all the sports is gone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we'll see. Like you said, it's gonna be interesting though.
But thank you for coming on, my brother.
Yo, bro, appreciate
y'all
having me on,
man. You know what I'm saying? You're always welcome to the show. Anytime you got something dropping, you know, like I said, send it over. We definitely going to show love to it. And keep doing your thing, man. We here to give you your flowers. And, you know, you've been putting it down for an easy 10 years, man. Easy, you know. And just keep doing your thing because, you know, you're bound to shine, my brother, for real.
For sure, man.
23
years deep now, man.
Yeah. Yeah, you made your mark, man. You still making your mark. You know what I'm saying? You got RJ Payne joint coming. Like, can't wait to hear that. You know?
Yeah, man.
You know, I'm going to
definitely keep you updated with that.
Yeah. We on deck, too. You know what I'm saying? You ever need us, man. We on deck, man.
For sure, bro. Appreciate y'all.
All right. Well,